University. So I find this very interesting that this is the book that has got the most information on the pineal, in terms of pineal physiology and history, etc., that I have actually read. And this was in 1984, but it's actually a British publication, it's Cambridge University Press. That this book on hormonal control of reproduction should have so much more about the pineal, which is an organ in the brain, than essentials in neuroscience and behavior, seems to me somewhat incongruous. Then if you go back and look at the textbook that I studied from, which was Psychology and Life, Philip Zimbardo, from Stanford University, this is a 1978 textbook, 1979, this doesn't mention the pineal or melatonin at all. This is a psychology book. Carry on, Inside the Brain, 1995, this is a small book, it's a popular book on the brain, so it's supposedly giving an overview of the brain. And supposedly after researching 300 brain researchers and the recent textbook, the recent history of brain science in the last 10 years, so it's supposed to be very much up to date. Ronald Kotelak won a Pulitzer Prize for a series on the brain in the Chicago Tribune. This book is very interesting because it goes through a lot of stuff about serotonin. It links low serotonin levels with violence, low serotonin levels with genetic and environmental link, low serotonin levels with suicide, obsessive compulsive disorder, and a range of other problems. And it fails to mention the pineal or melatonin at all, and doesn't even mention the fact that there's a high concentration of serotonin in the pineal. Interestingly, this book quite unashamedly promotes the psychoactive drugs and the SSRI antidepressants. So this is more, you could say, a popular science ad for the new psychoactive drugs. If I showed, and when I did in fact show this book to the psychiatrists, they weren't very interested because they said this is Ronald Kotelak's not a psychiatrist. He's actually a reporter. Fair enough. Okay, so then you can look at this book, which is Fundamentals of Human Neuropsychology. This is a 1990 book. A book has a diagram. It actually doesn't say anything about the pineal apart from long-term circadian rhythms. And it has a little diagram over here. Not sure if we can see that. It says four long-term circadian rhythms pineal. Four is not actually where the pineal is. Pineal is over here, where three is. And he doesn't actually say any of this. Now, this book
is giving the wrong location of the pineal gland.
Giving the wrong location of the pineal.
And who's that book geared at?
This is a detailed neuropsychology book. So it's designed, let's see who they say it's for. This is from the University of Lethbridge, published by W.H. Freeman and Company in New York. When we began to write the first edition of this book in 1977, neuropsychology as a unified field was just emerging. Researchers working with human and non-human subjects, respectively, worked largely independently of one another, and there were suggestions of significant difference in the organization of human and non-human brains, especially with respect to memory processes. 1980s have seen rapid change, however, as there have been significant changes on two fronts, both of which have led to the development of a more unified discipline. So they are recognizing the problem. But this is the first edition of this book was written for senior undergraduates interested in human brain function. We found that the book had a wider appeal, however, especially to graduate students and those whose area of training was not in behavioral neuroscience. So this is supposed to be for undergraduates and postgraduates. And this basically, you'd expect that
book... You might spend 6 or 7 years at a university and not know that the pineal gland exists, and if you do know it exists, you might be misinformed as its exact location in the brain.
Yeah, well, that's that's possible. It happened to me. six years in medical school, and another 3 years in the hospital, plus something like 10 years in continued medical education for general practitioners, and I knew nothing about the pineal. I discovered it by myself in 1995. And the source of that was really completely outside. It was not even from what would be considered to be a scientific source. It was me thinking about chakras and thinking about the third eye, and then realizing that the third eye was actually a reference to the pineal, and then going and researching it. Yeah, it seems quite extraordinary. I mean, this could be just a mistake in the wrong area.
Book,
well, somebody who didn't edit it very well, perhaps. But there is a person who has been researching this in a lot more for a lot longer, who's Deborah Graham, who's a psychologist in James Cook University in Cairns. And she wrote a chapter, and she actually edited the book. But it was a book called Decade of the Brain, and it was bringing the discoveries, neuroscience's discoveries in the last 10 years, and this is published in the 1990s. She actually wrote the chapter on the pineal and made the point that it seemed quite extraordinary to her that the medical ignorance surrounding the pineal through most of this century, saying that such a vital and important organ could have been so ignored. She had actually noticed that there was a systematic or large amount of misinformation about the pineal, which she considered to be accidental, until I started drawing her attention to how extraordinary it was. She had apparently been contacting editors in the different companies and saying, oh, you seem to have made a mistake, you've confused the pineal and the pituitary, or you've left out the pineal, or something like that. Subsequently, I just, looking at how widespread this misinformation is and affecting so many different neurosciences books, I really can't see that it's accidental. Because it goes even more than this. You can look at a book like this, Pathophysiology. Now, this is for nurses. This is a nursing textbook. But it does mention the pituitary. This is a 1982 book. It mentions the pituitary. Mentions the midbrain, but it completely omits to mention the pineal or melatonin. Now, that's a 1982 book. Comparative Animal Physiology, this is the international edition again. This is, let's have a look, a more recent book, 1990-something. This is by Philip Withers, a senior lecturer in Department of Zoology, University of Western Australia, and it's published by Saunders Publishing, which is another multinational corporation publication house. This is a 1992 book. It says here, it has a little section on the pineal gland, explaining where the pineal is, and that vertebrates, some vertebrates appear to lack a pineal organ, hagfish, crocodiles, armadillos, sloths. And that these animals don't have pineals. But they say the pineal glands of birds and mammals are the best studied, at least with respect to endocrine function. The first indication of physiologically active secretion by the mammalian pineal was observation that extracts from cow pineal glands induced blanching in frog tadpoles. This blanching factor is an indolic compound, melatonin. And then they write, melanin is synthesized from tryptophan, then serotonin, by the enzyme serotonin N-acetyltransferase and hydroxyindole-O-methyltransferase. Now, they've made a mistake again, right? They've said melanin rather than melatonin. Now, it could be a typographical error again. But it seems extraordinary the number of typographical errors that seem to affect information about the pineal. Melanin is in fact the dark pigment in the skin.